Hi, this is Dr. A with your medical terminology video on the signs and symptoms and pathologies of the eye. So we're going to start with the signs and symptoms. So blepharoptosis is a drooping eyelid. Sacroplegia is a paralysis of the ciliary body. Diplopia is double vision, and emmetropia is a state of normal vision. Iridoplegia is paralysis of the iris. And nyctalopia is difficulty seeing in dim light, also known as night blindness. Ophthalmalgia is eye pain. Ophthalmoplegia is a paralysis of one or more of the extraocular eye muscles. Ophthalmorrhagia is a bleeding from the eye. Papilledema is a swelling of the optic disc. It's also called a choked disc. Photophobia is a strong sensitivity to bright light. And presbyopia is expected changes in vision due to normal aging. Scleromalacia is a softening of the sclera, and xerophthalmia is a condition of dry eyes. Next, we're going to go over some eyeball pathology. So achromatopsia is a severe congenital deficiency in color vision. It is a complete color blindness. Amblyopia is loss of vision, not as a result of eye pathology. It is commonly called a lazy eye. Amblyo means dull. Astigmatism is a condition in which light rays are focused unevenly on the retina due to an abnormal curvature of the cornea. And I means no, and stigmato means points, so no point, it doesn't come to a precise point for the focusing of the light rays. Cataract is the development of an opaque or cloudy lens, and this results in diminished vision. A corneal abrasion is a scraping injury to the cornea. This is an example of what a cataract would look like. You can see the cloudiness and opacity in that lens. Glaucoma is an increase in intraocular pressure. It can result in an atrophy of the optic nerve and blindness. Hyperopia is a condition in which a person can see things in the distance, but has trouble reading material at close range. It is also called farsightedness. Iritis is an inflammation of the iris, and keratitis is an inflammation of the cornea. So here is an illustration of hyperopia or farsightedness. And so what happens is the way the cornea and lens bend the light rays is it focus the image past the retina. And so therefore it's blurry and hard to see. And with the corrective lenses, the corrective lenses bend the light rays so that the image is appropriately focused on the retina, on the back of the eye. To be legally blind is to be severely impaired with severely impaired vision. The visual acuity of 20 to 200 that cannot be improved with corrected lenses, or a visual field of less than 20 degrees. Macular degeneration is the deterioration of the macular area of the retina, which is the area of vision. Monochromatism is the inability to perceive one color. And myopia is a condition in which a person can see clearly up close, but not at a distance. It is also called nearsightedness, and myo means shut. And that's because people that are nearsighted will kind of squint and almost shut their eyes to try to be able to focus and see what's in the distance. So here's an illustration of myopia or nearsightedness. And you can see here where the image is focused in front of, but not on the retina, not on the back of the eyeball. So it's a little bit ahead there. And so that makes it blurry. And if you have corrective lenses, then it allows the image to be focused on the proper area of the retina. Oculomycosis is a fungus infection of the eye. Retinal detachment is a separation of the retina from the choroid layer, and this damages the blood vessels and nerves, and it can cause blindness, and this can happen with a blow to the head, for example. Retinitis pigmentosa is a progressive disease in which the retina becomes hard, pigmented, and atrophied. And retinoblastoma is a malignant eye tumor occurring in children. Retinopathy is a general term for disease affecting the retina. It is often related to diabetes and or to high blood pressure. Scleritis is an inflammation of the sclera. And uveitis is an inflammation of the choroid layer of the eye. So next we have conjunctiva pathology. So conjunctivitis is inflammation of the conjunctiva, usually from bacterial infection. It is also called pink eye. Pterygium is a hypertrophied conjunctival tissue in the inner corner of the eye. Blepharitis is an inflammation of the eyelid, because now we're in eyelid pathology. And hordeolum is a purulent inflammatory infection of the sebaceous gland of the eyelid. It is also called a sty. You can spell it S-T-Y-E or S-T-Y. And then lacrimal apparatus pathology, we have dacryoadenitis. It's an inflammation of the lacrimal gland. This gland is adeno, and dacryo is tear. And then we have dacryocystitis, is an inflammation of the lacrimal sac. This sac is cyst. And then we have eye muscle pathology. We have estropia, is an inward turning of the eye. People with this form of strabismus are sometimes said to be cross-eyed. And exotropia is an outward turning of the eye. People with this form of strabismus are sometimes said to be wall-eyed. And then strabismus is eye muscle weakness that results in the eyes looking in different directions at the same time. And then we have brain-related vision pathologies. So we have hemianopia is the loss of vision in half of the visual field. It is often the result of a stroke. And nystagmus is a jerky, involuntary eye movement. It often indicates brain injury, and the eye is just moving a little bit there without voluntary control. All right, so that should wrap it up for our pathologies that are related to the eye and then the signs and symptoms related to the eye.